Namaste students. Today in this lecture I am going to teach you about the concave lens and how the image are formed by the concave lens. Now first of all, what is a concave lens? A lens which is thin from middle, that between, and the thick from its periphery edge, that is known as a concave lens. Now the points about the concave lens, the very first point is the optical center. Optical center, the geometrical center of this point of this lens, that is known as a optical center. It is represented by point O. Now second is principal axis. Principal axis is same as we have learned in a convex lens, a line which is perpendicular to both the surface and passing through the optical center, that is known as a principal axis. Now third is principal focus. Principal focus, now principal focus is a point on the principal axis, on the principal axis, to which a ray of light which is parallel, which falls parallel to the principal axis on lens, appears to basically actually this diverge, and it appears to come from this focus. So this is the principal focus. Please remember, in case of convex lens, principal focus was the opposite side. If suppose ray of light falls from this side, so this is the principal focus, and in this concave lens, principal focus is on the same side, fine, and this is the other focus, f dash. Now fourth is the focal length. The distance between the optical center and the principal focus, that is known as a focal length, that is OF is a focal length, principal focus is F, optical center is O. Next is rules for obtaining images formed by concave lens. Rules means there are the same three principal rays, based on that we will learn where the image is formed in case of the different location of the object. The very first point is a ray of light falling parallel to principal axis diverge. As the rays gets diverged, so other name of the concave lens is diverging lens. Diverging lens. Principal axis diverge appears to pass through focus, or we can say that appears to come through the focus. Now, for example, this is a diagram for the concave lens. Now, this is the principal axis. This is the optical center O. A ray of light falling parallel to the principal axis. Basically, it diverges, as I told you earlier, and it seems to be coming from the focus. As it is imaginary ray, so this is a dotted one. This point is known as a focus, and this is a rule number one. The second point, a ray of light passing through optical center goes undeviated this point is same as in case of a convex lens. Now this is a concave lens. A ray of light passing through optical center will go undeviatedly, that is straight way. Now a third point is, a ray of light goes towards focus after reflection, it will go parallel to principal axis. Parallel to diagram is like this. This is a concave lens. This is optical center O, and this is a first focus. This is another focus. Suppose a ray of light coming from top and goes towards the focus. So after refraction, it will go parallel to the principal axis. Must show the arrow in each step of the ray diagram, otherwise marks will be deducted. Next is the image formed by a concave lens. In this case, in case of concave lens, we have only two types. The very first is when object is at infinity. That only two case when object is at infinity. Now when object is at the infinity, this is a convex lens, this is a principal axis, optical center now object is at the infinity, so parallel ray of light will fall on concave lens. First parallel ray, and after refraction it will diverge. Second parallel ray will take downside, coming from infinity. After refraction it will diverge, but it seems to come from this focus. Fine. So this appears to come from the focus. So in this case, image is formed at focus. The types of the images: virtual and erect, whereas the size is highly diminished. Now, second case is when object is between infinity and optical center. In this case, again we'll take any of the two ray from those three principal rays, the convex lens, the optical center. This is the first focus, this is another focus. Now first of all, when object is anywhere from infinity to optical center, let this the object be here. Now first ray, a ray of light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, it will go, it will diverge and appears to come from this focus. And second ray of light, let us take a ray of light passing through the optical center, which go straight undeviatedly. So where the two ray One is this one, which is passing through optical center, and second ray of light which appears to come from the focus, they will meet. So image will form here. Suppose this A and B is an size of an image, so A dash and this point B dash is a height of an image. Sorry, AB is a height of an object, A dash B dash is a height of an image. In this one case, image is again virtual and erect, and second case the size of the image is highly diminished. So these are the only two cases in case of a concave lens. Next topic is use of concave lens. The very first use of concave lens is correction of myopia, or that is other name of myopia is a short sightedness. It is a disease, it is a defect in the eye, not a disease, it is a defect in the eye in which a person can see nearby object but cannot see the far off object. So to correct that defect, we use concave lens. Second, it is used as an eyepiece lens in Galileo telescope. This concave lens also used with convex lens in optical instrument, and fourth is also used in doors for wide range for spy. Now, how to distinguish between a convex lens and a concave lens without touching them? Let both the lens be kept on one of the notebook. If the image formed by a lens seems to be enlarged, then it is a convex lens. If the image formed seems to be diminished, that is very small, then it is a concave lens. Because in case of concave lens, all the image formed is the very small one. Next, the sign convention for the spherical lenses, that which distance to be taken as a positive or negative and from where. 5 points are there. The very first point is all distance are measured from the optical center, that is the center of a lens, whether it is concave or convex. These are for the both. Second, distance measured in same direction of the incident ray is taken as positive. Fine, if suppose a ray of light is coming from this one side, and this is a convex lens, this is optical center. So from optical center towards this one right side, that is a positive, and towards left side, that is negative. So distance measured against the direction of the incident ray is taken as a negative. Suppose a ray of light is coming from left hand side to right hand side, and distance is measured from the optical center, so distance toward left will be taken as a negative. I'm just underlined in the same direction of incident ray taken as positive, against the direction of incident ray taken as negative. Now fourth point is distance measured above the principal axis is taken as a positive. So the object which is lying above the principal axis, the height, will take as a positive, and distance measured below the principal axis is taken as a negative.